not at the cost of you harming yourself. I think it's a very important message, because we have a tendency to try to help others at the cost of harming ourselves. If you harm yourself, you are not going to be able to help anybody else. So in order to help others, you have to also be helping yourself. Well, the heart is number four. So what is the message the heart has for us? You know, the heart, when it pumps, it's called systole. Systole is when all the muscles of the ventricles, they contract, and when they contract, they pump the blood out. If it's from the right ventricle, it goes to the lungs. If it is from the left ventricle, it goes to the rest of the body. Okay? But you know, when the heart is sending this blood to the lungs and to the rest of the body, or in general, when it is sending blood every place else, there is no blood going through the coronary arteries. So the heart is helping the whole body, but it is not supplying itself during systole, which is the contraction phase. It is when the heart starts to relax, the diastole, that is when the blood starts to flow in the coronary arteries. The heart supplies itself only during the relaxation phase, not during the activity phase. This is a very important message. Systole and diastole. Systole is the activation phase, the spanda, and the deactivation phase, the diastole, the neck spanda. During spanda contraction, the heart is supplying the whole body except itself. During the nishpanda, the relaxation, it is now supplying itself. Now, if you take this message into your yoga sadhana, whenever you are doing the practices, you are achieving one part of it, but you are not really helping yourself. It is when you relax that you are actually helping yourself. And that is why it is always important that spanda needs to be succeeded by nishpanda. Spanda, nishpanda, coupling, activation, deactivation, coupling is a must for physiological harmony, normalization, homeostasis to be there. If you are only contracting all the time without relaxation, you are not going to achieve anything. It's like if the heart is only contracting, it is not going to be supplying itself. And if it's going to be relaxing all the time, it's not going to be supplying anybody but itself. So the goal is not either one extreme or the other extreme. The goal lies in coupling, activation when required and deactivation when required. So the heart teaches us Dharma Yoga is not just helping others, but in between you have to rebuild and re-strengthen yourself so that you are of use to others. Because if you are weak and you are sick and you are in bed, who are you going to help? Nobody. So it is a very important message we get from the heart.